Bloomberg Television Worldwide, William Gross joins us. He is with Janice Henderson as we look at markets on the move. I know that on television, John Farrow and the team have been doing the market movement today, but yields higher, dollar stronger. Bill Gross, just simply, is it morning in America?
Well, it's certainly morning, beginning to be morning here in Newport Beach. I think to the extent that your question implies wages are moving higher and that, you know, the average wage earner will make more and spend more, I think that's probably a positive. I note that the wages, Tom, were revised higher in terms of the last month. And so we have a 2.7% YOY and perhaps headed higher. So I think that's good for American workers.
Within this is a pretty good revisions. I mean, we revised up, I guess, pre-hurricane and that. How does Janice Henderson adapt and adjust to the hurricane distraction?
Well, you basically try and throw it out for a month in terms of the employment numbers. You know, we're negative, as you mentioned, in terms of the job growth. So you throw that out. You look at the wages and you wonder whether or not that, to some extent, was affected by distortions, but probably not as much. And so this is definitely a situation here at Janus with analysis of the Fed, looking at the Fed, a rate hike in December. You know, as long as financial markets remain firm, they certainly are. As long as wages begin to rise towards, 3%, they certainly are. I think the Fed is slam dunk in terms of raising rates in December.
Yes. You know, John, David Weston's given me great charts on Bloomberg Daybreak on television, folks, of weaker Japanese yen. You've really got a jump condition to a weaker Japanese yen. And the idea here of a regime change. Bill Gross, not, you know, what you're going to do on this Friday morning in Newport Beach, but is there going to be a regime change within your Janus Unconstrained Fund? Because you're starting to get a little more lift and you're starting to get a little more wage growth.
Yeah, I think, you know, unconstrained basically means that you're not constrained in terms of duration. You can do other things as well. You know, the beauty of the unconstrained fund is it can go negative in terms of duration. That is basically looking for higher rates and making money off of higher rates as opposed to vice versa. And that's what, you know, we've done over the past few weeks, certainly in Germany and now in the U.S. You know, we're approaching critical levels, I think, Tom, on the 10-year, for instance, now probably at 240. I haven't seen it in the last minute. Mm-hmm. But now at 240, that we're at a 240, 245 critical level, a long-term downtrend line since the early 1980s, where interest rates have fallen.